Diamond Town, Hollywood, 1946. Me? Just a regular Joe by the name of Bigelow. Dick Bigelow, P.I. Life's not easy for a private dick. Just last Thursday, I was beating my boats, pounding my dogs, heading down to my favorite hooch hut, Club Orpheus. This joint was so sleazy it had more crabs than the Virgin Islands. But I didn't care, because I'm a sucker for a dancing dame that knows how to drag a sock. I go for the type who's from the opposite end of the planet. Dames that radiate danger. Like the dynamite dish who was headlining that night.
Ceremonies, Mr. Maxwell DeMille, here at the fabulous. Thank you very much. The master of ceremonies here at Club Orpheus, located in the heart of Broadway, an old downtown in Southern California's greatest summer playground. And tonight, it is my special honor to introduce our next gal, and boy, is she zoot zoot cute and hoy toy toy and solid to boot. Ladies and gentlemen, our own canary of song, please welcome Gail Tempest.
There's not a morning when I open up my eyes and find I didn't dream of you. Without a warning, no, it's never a surprise. Soon as I awake, thoughts of you arise. With every breath I take, at any time I close my eyes and see your face, and
Gentlemen, it's time to turn up the temperature a bit. So say you wolves, take off those muzzles and put your paws together for the exotic Tita Von Tees and her fan dance of destiny. Someone turned up the temperature, I'll say. But now, ladies and gentlemen, we'd like to take you to a different place altogether. A land of mystery and magic from that far-off kingdom of Mysteria. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome to the Club Orpheus stage, the great Nardini.
I need 2 volunteers from the audience. Yes. The couple right over here. Give them a round of applause.
Your name?
I'm Bab.
Bab. And your name is?
Ralph.
Ralph.
We're on our honeymoon.
They're on their honeymoon, ladies and gentlemen. Give them a round of applause. Glad to see you're up and around. Okay. Have you ever worked with a magician before? Good. Because, ladies and gentlemen, what I'm about to do is set a world's record of releasing myself from a straitjacket. Straitjacket. Thank you. Are you familiar with one of these? You are. No. Good answer. Okay. What I'd like you to do is examine and make sure there's no trapdoors over here. There's no strings attached to any of it. Just check it out. Very good.
Thank you.
Now, what I'd like you to do is come on over around here. Turn around right over here and buckle it up as quickly as possible. Because I'm going to attempt to break the world's record of 60 seconds getting out of a legitimate straitjacket. Tightly all the way down, all the buckles. Make sure all the straps are secure and tight. Very good, Ralph. Now, Babs, do you see what's dangling between my legs? Yeah, don't jerk. Ralph, pull that. Tight, 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 real tight, 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 tight. Yeah, tight. Good. That's tight. I'm going to attempt to break the world's record, ladies and gentlemen, of getting out of a straitjacket in 2 minutes. And now, ladies and gentlemen, are you ready?
Yeah.
Maestro, a little music, please. I have an announcement to make. Ladies and gentlemen, my lovely assistant Trixie has agreed to become Mrs. Nadini. And now, ladies and gentlemen, what I'd like to present to you is a death-defying illusion, the temple from Tibetan. Maestro, music, please.
the last sword, the death sword.
Nadini's on the square. Sure, he stood to gain big bucks. Cabbage, Guinness, lettuce. But he didn't ice the skirt.
Okay, gumshoe, I'm listening. But make it snappy. There's an electric chair waiting, and it's got Nadini's name written on the reservation card.
At first, I thought he might have been your man. But then I used my peepers to ice sweep the joint. Something wasn't Jake. The killer's here, all right. But it ain't magic, boy. Perhaps Ramon Raquel, if that is your real name. Stood to gain a few bucks, for in truth, he's actually Trixie's estranged first husband.
What?
Or could it have been the beautiful Dita Von Teese, also known as the Black Tarantula? Who has knocked off five of her former lovers. But that's a different story. The truth lies elsewhere. I never knew murder could smell like honeysuckle. Sorry, doll, but you're taking the fall.
Sure, I did it! And I do it again! I couldn't let my nitty marry that floozy! Oh, I'm sorry, Maxie. I only said I loved you so's you'd fix the trick. Just kill the only thing standing between me and my true love. The great Nadini.
You no-good double-crossing dame. You told me that after Nadini was fried for the murder, it would be you and me on the honeymoon express.
What?
as long as I live. Huh.
Get him, boys. What? Grab him. Come on. Listen, DeMille. Murder's not like taking a trolley ride together, where you can get off at different stops. You and the doll are stuck with each other, and you've got to ride all the way to the end of the line, and it's a one-way trip, and the last stop is the cemetery.
Waiter! Sir! Come over here. Get this out of here. Come on, take her away.
Right away, sir.
Hurry up. Let's see. Get your bride. Take her out of here. Come on.
My God. She's having a good job.
So that was it. All neatly wrapped up and ready to go like a cheap Chinese dinner. But for me, it was just another day in the life of a private dick. A pointless and lonely life, where you feel like you're going around in circles like a drunk with one foot nailed to the floor. Of course, there were a few things in this crazy, mixed-up town I could count on. Cheap booze, cheap floozies, and a dance or two at the Club Orpheus.
Thank you.